Image copyright Getty Images. Image caption: Mr. G finally made his escape from North Korea in 2006. The harrowing tale of a North Korean defector was part of the set at U.S. President Donald Trump's first ever State of the Union address. G. Seong-ho waved his crutches in the air to resounding applause. But what is his story? Who is G. Seong-ho? Few people had heard of G. Seong-ho when Donald Trump addressed him from the podium. In 1996, Seong-ho was a starving boy in North Korea, began Mr. Trump, as he went on to describe the extent of Mr. G's suffering as a teenager in the mid-1990s when North Korea was gripped by a devastating famine. That year, Mr. G tried to steal coal from a railroad car so he could exchange it for food. He managed to clamber on, but lost consciousness as a result of his extreme hunger. He awoke to find that he had fallen through a gap between train carriages onto the tracks, and at that moment a train ran over his limbs. He survived the accident, but his left hand and leg were severed. Mr. G was taken to hospital and operated on without morphine, a general anesthetic. The surgery took 4.5 hours. The defector has spoken out about his ordeal before this. "I was screaming so much that the sound would have been like watching an action movie in the cinema," he told a human rights group in an interview published by The Guardian. Nobody helped. How did he escape North Korea? In 2000, Mr. G decided to cross the border to China to search for food and traversed a mountain with his wooden crutches. But when he returned, he was arrested and tortured by North Korean authorities. It was only in 2006 that he finally decided to permanently escape North Korea with his brother. They crossed into China through the Tumen River and later decided to split up, with Mr. G fearing his disability would get them both captured. With the help of others, Mr. G trekked across China on his crutches and eventually made it to South Korea, where he was reunited with his brother. The boys later tried to contact their father, who had remained behind in the North Korean city of Hoayoung. According to an interview with a Freedom Collection, the duo were supposed to go back to get their father once they had settled in South Korea, but found that he had tried to escape himself but failed. He was caught by authorities and tortured to death. What does he do now? Today, the 36-year-old lives in Seoul, where he has gone on to help other North Korean defectors. Image copyright Getty Images. Image caption: Mr. G now speaks in global conferences to shed light into conditions in North Korea. He founded the Now Action Unity human rights organization, NAUH organization, which aims to raise awareness of the conditions that the North Korean people live in. He has spoken in conferences across the world, including the Oslo Freedom Forum in 2015, where he gave a speech titled "My Impossible Escape from North Korea: How Did People React?" Mr. G was greeted by thunderous applause in the House chamber and received an equally warm reception online. Many on social media called him an inspiration, though others highlighted that he would not be able to enter the U.S. as a North Korean refugee under current immigration rules. Skip Twitter post by @CharizMammy Trump out here praising a North Korean refugee for being so brave for traveling to China, but only because he didn't refuge to the U.S. so illegal immigrants are okay as long as they're not here thinking face weird BC people from El Salvador do the same trick to get to the U.S. SOTU2018. Erin T. @CharizMammy January 31, 2018. End of Twitter post by @CharizMammy. The speech was Mr. Trump's first ever State of the Union speech to Congress, and in the address, the U.S. president also condemned North Korea, calling it depraved. He warned that the U.S. was waging a campaign of maximum pressure to prevent Pyongyang's pursuit of nuclear missiles, but Mr. G's story of endurance through suffering, as he held up the crutches he used to escape North Korea, is what won over the audience.